Hello and welcome to the Every Ancillary Sales Podcast. I'm your host, Michael Berg, joined as always by Viv Hudson. Viv, I'll let you do the honors. We have a return guest and one of our favorites.
Yes, absolutely. Robert Castenada has been on numerous times, mainly because he has a lot of passion around being successful in sales and he walks the talk. So welcome to the show today, Robert.
Thanks, Mike. Thanks, Viv. I appreciate it. It's an honor to be back. Miss you guys.
We'll be back your way soon enough. Awesome. So Robert, this is what I wanted to talk to you about, because we have all sorts of distributors who use the Every Ancillary platform, or some people who don't use their platform at all that listen to this podcast that we hear from. And we have people of all varying levels, people who've been 25 years in medical sales, presidents, club award winners, to people that are just starting out. So what I really wanted to pick your brain about today, Robert, is more about thinking big, because what you've been able to do, I think, is a replicatable model. But I think sometimes people put governors in their own heads about what's possible in this business. And I thought it'd be useful to hear from you about how you set your targets and what thinking big in this business means to you in terms of, from a rep standpoint, income potential. So can you just maybe tease that out a little bit and break it down for me?
Absolutely. I mean, you know, that's I think the reason why we get up early and go to bed late is to make as much as possible for our efforts, our marketing efforts, especially as a rep in this field. It's fairly competitive and you have to be always on your toes. And so what I like to do is what I usually do when I enter into new industry, or if I'm in my set industry, and I immediately set a goal, right? And I have that phrase where, you know, aim for the stars. And if you at least break orbit, you know, you're doing well. So, and that's what I do, is I give myself three goals. One being what's best case, and then, you know, what's somewhat what I think attainable and realistic within a certain amount of time. And then what's worst case, how can I keep going and keep myself sustained until I can reach that next level? So that way I have an idea of, okay, well, these are the three goals I have. I know if I aim for the stars and I at least just break Earth's orbit, I'll be somewhat good. And then I lay out my plan. Okay, who are my target clients, and what potential income do I have? And which program do I feel much comfortable presenting to this client? And I start with low-hanging fruit, the lowest possible thing. It may not make the most money, but it'll get me in the door. And I like those better than going for the most money first, because then you lose the opportunity of establishing a strong rapport and relationship with the clinic. So I like something that I can really wrap my mind around and execute, of course, with the help of the platform. Every Ancillary has a great video and tutorial, and actually some of them you can actually just let the video do the selling for you. It's that good. So I do that initially to get the wheels greased.
So you mentioned before, I mean, first of all, I think it's great to have goals, and too many people just get out of bed and let the day flow. And by having goals, it kind of gives you that action plan and helps you to remember what you're working towards. But plenty of us have been kicked in the teeth countless times, and that's probably one of the big reasons why people give up. So when you get kicked in the teeth, and I know it's happened, tell me what you do to power through.
Yes. So, you know, one thing that you got to have some thick skin in sales, right? In marketing, you got to be able to get yourself back up, dust yourself off, and keep that attitude. Because I listen to some of the, like Zig Ziglar sayings, for every no, there's a yes. Helping others will help you get to your goal quicker. So sometimes, believe it or not, just by helping people in a clinic, you never know who you're helping. It could be the physician's wife. It could be the physician himself, but just she or he is dressed like everyone else in the clinic, so you can't really distinguish. But sometimes just having that servant spirit, that helpful spirit, even when getting kicked in the teeth, helps that positive momentum come back to you. So I've been shut down, guys. You know, I say to myself every time before I go into a pitch meeting in a clinic, I say, you know, I just kind of center myself in my vehicle, make sure I have everything ready, somewhat ready, because you never know how it's really going to go when you get in there until you're in there. But I center myself and then I say, okay, I'm going to do the best I can possibly do here in this meeting to convey my message. Regardless if it's a yes or a no, I'm going to do my best. And I'm going to try to be the best version of myself around the people that are there. So just in case I do get shot down, at least they say, well, that guy, at least, you know, he really gave it that effort. And I tell you, you keep that attitude. And I always think for every no, there's a yes, because even though you say no, you know, there's that tell me more, because you're not really convincing me. Give me a little bit more information, or maybe you're not really presenting it the way he or she wants to hear it. Sometimes it's just a matter of the way you present the program in their environment and how it would work to streamline it and make it successful is key. So all these factors I take into consideration prior to going in. Some of the times, you know, right now my batting average is a lot higher. I'm more, it's turned. It's, you know, I'm a 90-10er, but before it was the other way around. 10 pitches, 9 said no, and I got 1 yes, but I didn't stop until I got a yes, or at least a second meeting. You know, okay, doc, maybe right now you're not ready for this, but can we schedule something else, maybe with your, you know, your office manager or your nurse practitioner, and can us, let's all get together and see if this is something that could really fit, because I feel like there's synergies here, but maybe we need to get more of your clinic involved and see what they think. Always try to don't accept no right immediately. Find other ways of communicating your message and reaching out, whether it's a video from the platform, from Every Ancillary, or maybe you guys have great subject matter with each program. Maybe you discuss part of that program, because you have the exact, if you could memorize the platform's description of the program, it's the perfect pitch. Just make it your own.
I'm sorry, go ahead, Robert.
That's what I do. I look it over, the program on Every Answer on the platform, and then I internalize it and make it my own without deviating from the core benefits of what you list in Every Ancillary. So and I found it to be very successful.
So, Robert, let's talk numbers, because people ask me about numbers all the time and what is realistic. Now, granted, you've been out there in the field. We can hear you. You're in your car. Why is Robert in his car? Because it's 1 o'clock. There's no way Robert's not going to be out in the field. This is part of why you're successful. But what if you were starting out, knowing what you know now, if we were to wipe the slate clean, or I just brought you into a brand new territory.
Yes.
I said, all right, Robert, you got to start building a new business here. What kind of goals would you set for yourself based on what you know is attainable, and how many practices, and what would that annual or monthly income be that you'd be trying to ramp up to?
Ah, this is the fun stuff. This is what I love. I love projecting, because projecting to me, I'm a very visual person. So if I can visualize where my goal is or what I want to attain, it makes it exciting and it makes it a game. So what I do is, if it's a new territory and I'm breaking into this area, I would make it a point to first the lowest hanging fruit possible, which the programs that I draw from Every Answer are the lab programs, urine toxicology, blood wellness, blood allergy, and RX compound pharmacy. So these are the things that's my wheelhouse. That's what I understand and what I can convey the message properly, and nail path and so on onychomycosis. So I would make it a point that before noon to be in front of at least 10 clinics. 10 clinics, office managers, the front desk, hopefully a doc, maybe, because usually in the initial visit, you don't get that. You get people that are the buffers, the vetters, and so on. So I try to make my pitch very short, because I know it's my initial meeting. Give them just the facts and give them something that, a carrot, like, look, this program is beneficial in this way. And no cost to the patient. No, you know, we work within the copay, and you get fast results. And doc, you don't get invoiced like the national companies do. We don't charge you. It's free service for you. things like that.
I'm salivating here, Robert. Get to the numbers. I want to hear what are the numbers. What would you set your target at for the next 12 months? If I brought you here in my territory, you don't know anybody. I said, just start from scratch. What do you think you would be at a year from now? What would you set your goal at for monthly income, and how many accounts would it take to get there?
$30,000 a month first year. And I would do that by doing visiting 10 accounts a day. I would say out of the 10, my closing ratio brand new would be a 10% closing ratio. I'd close one clinic per 10, whether it took me 2 days to do that. I do two and a half new accounts a week. Each one would probably make anywhere from 3 to 8,000. So about 6 to 18,000 a week in estimated gross revenue. Of course, you got to back out stuff, you know, that we do. But I would say I could more than likely go pick any place that is friendly to the programs that I use on every ancillary in any state in this country. Give me 12 months and I'll make $360,000 a year too. $30,000 a month. I could do that with five clinics, each making me $6,000 a month. And I can split that into three modalities: molecular swabs, blood, and urine. Those three. Scripts is just a bonus. You know, those will take me over the top. I'll make $40,000 a month. And you think, wow, you know, people are used to making that a year. Well, you're not. You're creating your own world, and then you're walking in it. You know, you're making your own path. This is entrepreneurship at its best, at its purest form. Yes, you're not a drug rep. You're not a lab rep. You're an ancillary rep. You hold the keys to so many different treasure chests, possible avenues of revenue for the clinic and the physician and yourself. I mean, even if you stumble across this formula, visit 10 clinics a day, your closing ratio, even if it's 10%, even if you close one out of every 10, I promise you, you'll make $30,000 a month at the end of year one. Just to give you an example, that's basically what happened to me. But year two, two and a half, my company grossed 2.2. So, you know, and that's not 1,000. So, you know, that's just me. Fast forward to now I'm opening my own brick and mortar laboratory, high complexity laboratory. And I'm doing both. I'm doing ancillary. I got an ancillary company, and I've got my laboratory, and which opens in a few weeks. And it's amazing. I love the ancillary space. It's allowed me the freedom to work as many hours as I want, or as little hours as I want, and still maintain with my core 10 clients. And sometimes commissions are $50,000 a month, guys.
You know, the voice of confidence and experience. And I think, Robert, what have you been in this space? 3 years, maybe no more than four, something like that. So, so in 3 to 4 years, you can be creating easily a seven-figure salary yourself and setting up your own businesses. So the world is your oyster. It just takes that passion and perseverance and that confidence. So I want to say thanks a lot, Robert. Thanks for being on the show today. If you aren't already a member of Every Ancillary, go to everyancillary.com and make sure you register and sign up for that nice, boring business, some of those lab services, and they're the gift that keeps on giving. So thanks a lot.
My pleasure. Anytime.